here's how I feel about it, is that I think the ego wants to be happy. The soul is already happy. So in a sense, what is the ego? The ego is just our separate sense of self. Now, a separate sense of self, by definition, frankly, is terrified. To be a single self in the universe without any connection to anything is terrifying. That's the basis of neurosis. So we won't really be happy in that state. So the happiness that we can have in that state is normally called pleasure. So some great moments, pleasure, pain. Similarly, satisfaction, dissatisfaction. Satisfied? I'm satisfied because the world looks the way I want it to look right now. Hold on a minute, somebody just changed my world. Now I'm not so satisfied anymore. You know, I'm constantly arranging the furniture of my life to make it look the way I want it to look. But I'm living in a world where the furniture keeps changing around. So no wonder I'm not experiencing a permanent sense of happiness in this separated self, this separated state. When I relax, when I stop trying to be me, and I remember who I already am, when I go to that place which I sometimes call before the thought of I suddenly realize, my God, I actually feel pretty good here. Maybe I'm already happy. Maybe I'm already okay. Maybe the love I'm looking for in the world is just one of the qualities of my essence. Maybe the peace I'm looking for in the world, maybe that's a quality of my essence. The things I'm looking for in the world are just me trying to meet up with myself again, my true essence, if you like, the self this time that we all share. Now, I think that joy is constant. And I'll call it joy this time rather than pleasure and satisfaction. So pleasure and satisfaction are to do with the separate self. Joy is unreasonable happiness. It doesn't need a reason. It's here already, it's constant. So therefore, joy doesn't come and go. What comes and goes is my awareness of the joy. Does that make sense? It's me that's actually coming and going, not the joy, not the true self. So in a sense, that's always there. Now after that, as we begin to tune into joy, we become aware that it's dancing, that it has lots of qualities to it. It isn't monotone, it's not one color, it's dynamic, it's evolving, it's intelligent, it's alive, it's a fountain, it's creative. The substance of joy is always the same, but actually, so it's permanent in that sense, but actually it's riveting because it's taking on all of these different hues and flavors all of the time. So there's no way we could be bored with it. Because it's a symphony, it isn't just one instrument playing one note. You know, it's the whole symphony. And that joy is amazing. When we can connect to that joy, now we can run back out into the world, meet the personality again, and actually have a better time with satisfaction and pleasure than ever before. Because now the things that are happening in the world, we don't need them so much. We don't see the world as being the source of our happiness anymore. We see the world as a place for us to share the happiness. So in a sense, there can be a sense of a union here between that soul joy and also the satisfaction and the pleasure, if that makes sense. You don't need to, I like to say, like, you don't need to choose between one or the other, because if you choose joy, you know, then you will be able to be more satisfied and have more pleasure in the world. If you discount joy, discount the idea that joy is here, then unfortunately, no matter how much you shop for satisfaction and pleasure, you will always feel like you are one item behind, was one item missing, one thing was not quite right. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Thank you.
It's a great thing just to explore. I think ultimately we are one self. So we don't really have two selves. It's just we have to talk a little bit like that to begin with. There is an unconditioned self, and then there's a self I've learned to be. This is the subtleness of it. The person who's trying to be a good person, that's the persona, trying to be the good person. It's exhausting. until you relax and you tune into your essence and you go, oh my goodness, it's just goodness itself in there. I don't even need to be a good person because I've got goodness itself inside me. Do you see what I mean? It's like the same when somebody thinks they have to be a nice person. I mean, I think that's as exhausting as trying to be a good person. Imagine if that was the goal for your whole life, to be a nice person. I mean, it's terrifying, the thought of it. Who would want that? You know, and yet you tune into the essence of yourself and you find there's compassion in there, there's kindness in there, there's love in there already, so you don't even need to try to be nice now. Do you see what I mean? You can just be yourself and the niceness comes out. So that's the subtlety, I think, of all of this, is that we are really just one self. We are a natural, unconditioned self, and it's a self we all share with each other. But occasionally we take on these personalities, these personas to be in the world, and we get sort of almost stuck into them. So we end up in a role rather than as a person. So then we say, hello, my name is so-and-so and I'm a nice person. And, we wonder why we need to sleep 10 hours a night. But it's not a mystery. Being nice is exhausting. If you were just present, hello, this is who I am. Do you see what I mean? You were just present, all your niceness would pour out. And it would be a different story.